You.
Okay. Hit it. Oh, are you hit it? It's hit. It's
Yeah.
hit.
Yes.
All right. This is your obedient servant, a finish.
I was 17, an arrogant immigrant, orphan bastard, poor son, somehow endorsed Thomas Jefferson, his enemy, a man he's despised since the beginning, just to keep me from winning. I wanna be in the room where it happens, the room where it happens, the room where it happens. You've kept me from the room where it happens for the last time. Dear Alexander, I am slow to anger, but I toe the line as I reckon with the effects of your life on mine. I look back on where I failed, and in every place I checked, the only common thread has been your disrespect. Now you call me immoral, a dangerous disgrace. If you've got something to say, name a time and place, face to face. I have the honor to be your obedient servant, A. Dot Burr. Mr. Vice President, I am not the reason no one trusts you. No one knows what you believe. I will not equivocate on my opinion. I have always worn it on my sleeve. Even if I said what you think I said, you would need to cite a more specific grievance. Here's an itemized list of 30 years of disagreements. Sweet Jesus. Hey, I have not been shy. I am just a guy in the public eye, trying to do my best for our republic. I don't want to fight, but I won't apologize for doing what's right. I have the honor to be your obedient servant, A. Dot Hill. Careful how you proceed, good man. Intemperate indeed, good man. Answer for the accusations I lay at your feet. Or prepare to be good man. Though your grievance is legitimate, I stand by what I said every bit of it. You stand only for yourself. It's what you do. I can't apologize because it's true. Stand, Alexander. We hawking dawn. Guns drawn. You're wrong. I have the honor to be your obedient servant, A. Dot Hill, A. Dot Burr.